Welcome to the GoDaddy Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. From Ladd Peebles Stadium in Mobile, Alabama, tonight, the first ever bowl game for Georgia Southern, matching up with the MAC champs from Bowling Green. Welcome to Mobile, everybody. Tom Hart alongside. Shin versus the Fun Belt, and it should be a fun one in a soggy Ladd Peebles Stadium tonight. Happy holidays from Mobile. We kick off next.
Georgia Southern gets the option running. They want to make sure they don't give up big plays on the outside.
And your key to handle the weather arrives right on time. The weather has been dicey at best over the last 48 hours here in the Gulf. And rain expected throughout the night tonight. Tornado warning got the teams out of their hotel rooms this morning. Sent the guys from Georgia Southern down to the hotel basement for a good 30 minutes. Hopefully they got another nap before they're done. Bowling Green won the toss. The Falcons will receive. Youngway Koo gets us underway. First bowl game in Georgia Southern's grand history. And it starts with a touchback. And that tees up this high-powered offense for Bowling Green. Led by Matt Johnson.
They have gotten offsides early.
Scott Campbell is our referee tonight, this Mountain West Conference crew.
Offsides, number 21, kicking team. 5 yards will be added to the touchback spot. First down, Bowling Green.
It is rare to see an offsides call.
Passes, they've put up big completion percentage, but he takes care of the football.
He won the Sammy Ball Award as the nation's top passer. They will go empty a lot, and they will go fast. They start with five wide, and they fire it immediately, but the pass dropped and incomplete. Quick look
for defensive coordinator Jack Curtis. He told us that they were going to play. They weren't afraid to play man-to-man, get in the face of these receivers, and then punish them after the ball's delivered.
Travis Green is the running back. Two very talented running backs. Plenty of wide receivers to go through. Roger Lewis, as we mentioned earlier, is their leader. 82 catches and 15 touchdowns on the year.
Yeah, and he's down here at the bottom of the screen.
They go stack down there. Johnson will keep it. Pulled it back, and he slides his way just shy of the first down. That will leave third and short. Glover in on the stop again.
Yeah, which is where they love to operate. Bowling Green on the season, 51%.
And on the quarterback sneak, going up tempo for the first time, and a first down for 175 first downs this year. Johnson has time behind his veteran offensive line, and he fires it. It is complete to a sliding Roger Lewis. They give him credit for it, for a first down gain of 12.
Yeah, Roger Lewis, I think the country's going to get eligible to come out after this season. You'll see right there, just the right, the left foot actually touches.
And it looked like the right foot was out of bounds by the time the ball arrived as well.
Yeah, this is a view here that we may just very well make. See it right there. You see the toe tapping right out. Turn Bowling Green's defense around.
After review, the receiver was out of bounds before he caught the pass. Therefore, it's an incomplete pass. It'll be second down and 10 from the 42-yard line.
Goes across the middle. He's a complete receiver.
So second and 10 for Matt Johnson and Bowling Green. This is an offense that ran 105 plays in a win against Maryland earlier this season. Totaled 692 yards. Straight up the middle with Travis Green. Antoine Williams. Third down and 6 for Bowling Green. Johnson has all day. Deep ball for the first time and incomplete. Georgia. Derek Heaton back to receive the punt from Joseph Davidson. That'll take a hop, and it went off of a Bowling Green player. And we'll see where they mark that one. Should be up near the 18-yard line. Herve Colby, the gunner down there. And the ball kicked off of his hip.
Bowling Green's defense.
We'll also see Fabian Upshaw as early as the third series for Georgia Southern at quarterback. These two have combined for 3 touchdowns against 10 interceptions. Wesley Fields and Matt Breida in the backfield for Georgia Southern, the nation's best rushing team. And it's the quarterback, Ellison, who keeps it, and he's got room, able to slither his way to a gain of 14 on first down.
Just a little misdirection already with the option attack. They think you have you thinking inside.
Time of possession is key for this Georgia Southern option-based shotgun offense. They want to run the clock down as long as they can, try to help out their defense a little bit. Quarterback keeps it again. Now the pitch and room on the edge for Georgia Southern. And Derek Keaton, who's got a first down, leads the nation in yards per carry. 8.2 yards every time he touches the ball. And first touch, he gets popped and dropped. Nowhere to go.
Counter option.
Out of the shotgun. They fake the give. There's the triple. And a nice hurdle at the end of this one. I think the key that Doug Ruse talked to us about yesterday.
Jeff Ward, and he's basically a lead blocker. They will move him around. They'll make it look like triple option, but he's in there just for blocking purposes.
And anywhere on the field seems to be four down territory for Georgia Southern. They've gone for it 29 times this season and converted 62% of the time. Bowling Green shows blitz. Here comes an extra man, and they throw it for the first time. Out to Wesley Fields. Fields has a first down. He's inside the 30. They rarely throw the football, but when they do, they got guys who can make you miss. Again, at 17.
Excellent receiver out of the backfield, true freshman, and Wesley Fields. They blitz. He's able to pick it up, and a nice job by Kevin Ellison of seeing the blitz, finding the safety valve, or the go-to receiver in that situation, Fields, who converts it for the first down. This is an excellent start to this ball game for Georgia Southern offensively.
First possession for the Eagles. Breida back in at tailback. Breida gets taken down by the first man for the second time. Trenton Green, big
play for us more often. You've got to learn the scheme, and he's done that, put himself on the field full time.
He turned into an all-conference performer. Back to the option again. Ellison cuts it back up on the quarterback keeper. He's got another first down. Chunks of yardage in the running game for Georgia Southern. Austin Valdez finally brings him down after a gain of 18.
Yeah, talking with Brian Ward, they had not their schedule, and they're going to have some problems as they sort things out against Georgia Southern.
Already 39 yards rushing for Ellison to start this game. Ellison will cut it back up again, and he takes it to the 5, and a bump, dives for the pylon, and no signal. They'll say he's out just inside the 1. Eiler Hardy, the Notre Dame transfer, came up from his safety spot for the hit. It is a first down for Georgia Southern just outside the goal line, and Ellison talking with the trainer.
Remember I told you about Jeff Ward, number 96, lead blocker. When he comes in, just follow him, because the football usually follows the big fella, 6 foot 255 in Jeff Ward.
And a change of quarterback, Fabian Upshaw has entered now. He's in the backfield with L.A. Ramsby. Ellison went out holding his arm with the trainer. First touch and the pitch to Ramsby. He's in. First bowl, first possession, first touchdown for Georgia Southern in the FBS postseason. It's L.A. Ramsby who takes it in.
His 13th touchdown run of the year. And Fabian Upshaw comes in, does a nice job of putting pressure on the defense. It's easy. Let me just flip it and let Ramsey do the work here. Nice job of finishing the run.
A 9-play, 78-yard drive, 4 minutes and 34 seconds off the clock, and that will be a key for their offense tonight. Youngway Koo with the extra point. It is good. Georgia Southern on its first possession of its first ever bowl game marches down the field against Bowling Green and punches it in with the option pitch. It was Upshaw to Ramsby, and the Eagles with a hot start.
Football, where they feature Kevin Ellison, the quarterback, in that first drive.
No chance for a return, kicking with the wind. 3 plays per game. They're down to their second string quarterback, though, for that bowl game. Straight ahead run for Fred Coppett. And Georgia Southern's defense, this defense.
Yeah, they're going to run it down inside of 10 seconds on the play clock each and every time to really put some pressure on Bowling Green.
On second and eight, Johnson pulls it back and fires complete to Roger Lewis. And this is the basis of Bowling Green's offense. These run pass options to open up.
Let hands to just reach back and pluck it out of the air.
That was a gain of 19. Same play again, but it's batted away by Darius White. Great coverage.
Really want to reel that one in if you're White.
On second down, he pulls it back again. Johnson will throw on the run. That was a backwards pass. Turning upfield, Ronnie Moore. And he took a lick just past midfield.
Just under 900 yards receiving with five touchdowns to go along with it.
Third down and four. Short of the first down is Fred Coppett. He picked up three.
And if this holds true to form, Dino Babers is instilled. They cross the 50-yard line. All four downs are in play.
They've converted 56% of their fourth downs this season. Fourth and one. Bad snap. Johnson able to corral it. Fakes a throw. Pulls back. Launches downfield for Lewis. Roger Lewis will take it in on a fourth and one play. They ad-lib their way to a 45-yard touchdown pass.
Boy, the bad snap. It was supposed to have been a handoff. They've got so many things built in. Then Johnson makes it look as though he's going to run the football. They've got leverage and him covered up. White takes one look back inside, and it's too late. Roger Lewis, with too much speed and agility, he's not going to catch it.
Tyler Tate on for the extra point, and it's blocked by Georgia Southern. Chance for a scoop and score. Picked up by Matt Dobson. He's got the sideline and a convoy. Are we having fun yet? Two the other way. A 95-yard return. Darius White blocked it. Matt Dobson scooped it up. Through the years, this bowl has been known for some crazy plays. Instead of being tied on the extra point, Darius White rejects it, and Matt Dobson takes it to the hard way. Georgia Southern up 9-6.
Making up for it, though.
Nick Fields with a short kick into the wind and the rain. And it's taken at the 24-yard line. Opportunity for Georgia Southern for great field position as Patrick Flo, one of the upmen, returns it for 40.
Sudden change in a ball game. They were prepared for it.
Kevin Ellison is back at quarterback. Second possession for Georgia Southern. Matt Breida with another carry. This time positive yardage for Breida, who fights forward for four against his bowl finale against Georgia State. And missed the last three quarters of that one. Ellie Ramsey, Wesley Fields, and B.J. Johnson. A full house backfield with Kevin Ellison out of the diamond. Ellison fakes right, cuts it back almost straight up the middle, and ends up bending it left and picks up two.
Feature him. It's just the opposite, and a nice job by Doug Roos, their coordinator, of kind of switching things up and featuring Kevin Ellison.
They start with four wide, and then Ramsby returns to the backfield. Option right with Ellison and Ramsby. Nowhere to go. Well defended by Bowling Green, and that will bring up fourth. And Ruff is back to return this punt from Ryan Nowicki, the Ole Miss transfer. Kicking with the win. It's a good one. And Stevens asks for a fair catch, and he takes it inside the two. Lets that bounce. It probably goes into the end zone. As it stands, Nowicki gets into one, and he boots a 50-yarder. His first bowl game ever, Georgia Southern brought one of its great traditions along with them, or at least they acquired it here. A local bus company arranged for Georgia Southern to arrive in three Yellow Dog school buses. That goes back to one of the very earliest traditions in Georgia Southern football history. It was a program born under former Georgia coordinator Irk Russell, who came down to Statesboro in the early 80s. He named a drainage ditch near the practice fields Beautiful Eagle Creek, and he would take a jug of water from Eagle Creek out to their playoff opponent's fields. They acquired school buses for just a dollar from the county to get to and from their practice fields in on game day. And Freedom, a male bald eagle, is one of their other traditions that flies before each and every home game. Freedom made the trip out here today. Travis Green is the running back for Bowling Green. Matt Johnson goes play action and fires one incomplete. The players weren't aware that the Yellow Dog school buses would be here in Mobile. In fact, they didn't even know as a program they would have the school buses until some of their donors got together in a hospitality room meetup and said, how can we make this happen? And lo and behold, they pooled their money, said, we need to make this happen for their guys in the first ever bowl game. Tradition is so important to the program at Georgia Southern.
Tradition or superstition? Because that factors into a lot of players and coaches.
Well, with six FCS national championships and a Sun Belt,
I'd find some buses as well.
Yeah, you do what you can.
No doubt.
They
about
bought
it.
The buses from the county back in the day for just a dollar. I mean, when this program was born, they were dead broke. They bought their first football at the local Kmart, and to dress up the helmets, they just used a stripe of athletic tape right down the middle. And the practice pants, the white practice pants, were also their gamers. So that meant that they had one of the simplest uniform designs in all of college football. In fact, Sports Illustrated named it the third best college football uniform.
And you see, right, just a tight man-to-man coverage for Georgia Southern.
Johnson pressured, trying to get out of the end zone, and he flicks it downfield for a first down. A little bit more for Ronnie Moore. And Moore finally taken down inside the 20 by Matt.
Bottled up, and all of a sudden he escapes for a first down.
Another run pass option, and that one was too high, trying to find Garrick Dieter.
For their quarterback, Matt Johnson.
Here comes the rain again. Travis Green again. As heavy as the rain has been all night, and we expect sporadic thunderstorms throughout the evening here in Mobile.
Well, we've been here a couple of days, and it's been like this since we landed.
Good news is the ponchos are selling. Third and eight. Johnson pressured, lets it go deep in the rain, underthrown and incomplete. Coverage downfield.
This will be a challenge for Matt Johnson going forward here, especially through the remainder of this first quarter.
They're trying to come after this punt. Joseph Davidson gets off a line drive that is fielded at the 42 by Derek Keaton. Keaton changes direction, then just goes straight ahead. And he's able to make it past midfield. Daw, as planned, comes in for the third series, and he gets the rain. He's in trouble. Upshaw goes all the way back inside the 40. And we'll send this one downfield and just out of the reach of the Bowling Green defenders. I don't know if that one was a bust from the start, but it seemed like nobody was
averaging about 15 yards, over 15 yards per punt return. That is big in hidden yardage. He was first team all Sun Belt as a return specialist this year. So you match that with the season that Breida had. It's a lot of hidden yards.
Breida was bobbling the ball as he got the handoff. He's only able to find guys at the exchange. Ellie Ramsey now in at running back. Blitz coming for Bowling Green on third and nine. Upshaw in trouble again, and he finds the sideline again. Terrence Bush brought
first downs on third and long, but they're not throwing for very many first downs.
Trying to win the field position here. Stevens lets this one go over his head, takes a high hop and into the end zone, and we've got a flag down. 41-yard punt as it is. The touchback. Or the acting head coach, the interim head coach for Bowling Green. He's on to Syracuse to join Dino Babers.
Illegal formation will inform the backfield. Kicking team. That foul being forced from the touchback spot. 5 yards, first down.
Turned around. A nice season for Southern Miss this year.
Pump once and a deep ball. That one's complete for Bowling Green all the way to midfield. To T.O. for 11. The touchdown pass came on a busted play. Fred Coppett. And that big offensive line trying to move that pile a couple more yards. He picks up five. This offense.
More. It's hard to replace all the experience that, or overlook all the experience that they have up front on the offensive line.
Over the last two years, they've only missed five starts on the offensive line. Johnson pulls it back. Strong arm to the outside. It's bobbled by Garrick Dieter, and he's able to haul it.
Here, he had a huge game. against Tennessee in that opener.
Back to the running game. Coppett got spun around. Jay Ellison, second team all Sun Belt performer, in on the stop for Georgia Southern. 10. Sapp listed at 330. The coaches told us, well, this week of eating here in Mobile, maybe they added 15 each. Overthrown, nearly picked. Darius White was right there. And White went into the wall on this wet turf.
Slid right into that fence.
Senior from Belton, Texas, a junior college transfer in a scary moment. He was going full throttle.
Just started sliding. About.
Crazy start to this one, still in the first quarter. 9-6, Georgia Southern up front. Let's take you back to the studio and check in with Chris Cotter.
There with some give to it.
Third down and 8. Bowling Green just 2 of 5 on third down tonight. They go for the screen, and it's incomplete. Helmet popped, and we got a flag. Ronnie Moore lost his helmet on that big hit.
And it's Tay Hicklin, one of the safeties. He may have gotten a flag thrown at the tail end of this for a taunt. You see him here. Looks like a legal hit. Over the shoulder.
It was below the shoulders of
the shoulder. I was thinking it's for more for the taunt than it would be for targeting.
Well, that flag came out immediately.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. Number 14. Defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic. First down.
Well, we've got Greg Burks with us in the booth, Mountain West Conference Coordinator of Officials. Tay Hicklin flagged for that personal foul. Hey, Greg.
Timing of the issue on that hit. And that's a tough, tough call because you have to make that really, really quick. But I think he was right in this call. That was a little late. The defender should have recognized that the ball wasn't in play.
And the end result, Ronnie Moore is able to take it in for a 15-yard touchdown run. It's actually a pass for Matt Johnson. A little touch pass to Moore and able to take it in. So instead of facing a fourth down, it was an automatic first down plus 15 yards at that set.
Once he outflanks the defense, it's tough to catch him.
Tyler Tate with the extra point. After the previous one was blocked, and that makes it a 13-9 game. Greg, thanks for being. Off a high hop, Keaton scoops it at the 5 and steps out of bounds shy of the 20. Now for tonight's storyline, brought to you by K Jewelers. Breeders gets 16 rushing touchdowns on the year. Ellison trying to follow him. Gets turned around and gets thrown down. Now for Georgia Southern, Kevin Ellison at quarterback. His first drive, he engineered a 9-play, 78-yard scoring drive, including a 17-yard pass on a key play. Straight ahead, Wesley Fields, and Fields takes it to the 24, gain of 10. James Sanford in on the stop for the Falcons.
Yeah, Fields had over 600 yards rushing, 6 touchdowns as a true freshman, and he's third behind Breida, Ramsby, and then Fields, the youngster, comes in, gives him a nice dimension. We talked about how well he catches the ball out of the backfield. Had a nice check down earlier in this game to pick up a first down.
Third and 2 for the Eagles. Matt Breida. He just hasn't been able to find the space yet, and this will be close to a first down. Terrence Bush in on the distance is 35.2 yards. He can score from anywhere on the field. They gave him credit with the spot for the first down, but before the first down play gets off.
False start, number 58. Offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
That's fresh
for Georgia Southern.
So they'll try it again on first down. Ellison with the pitch to Fields. And that'll set up second and long.
Picked up the slack on the outside. Right here at the top of the screen.
Mike Jinks, the new head coach, awarded him a scholarship first team meeting back on December 10th. Here's Ramsby. Ramsby picks up five.
You know, the thing about for Georgia Southern, we take a look into the future. They're all back next year. Ellison, Upshaw, Ramsby, Breida, Fields, all of them are coming back, the entire backfield.
Ellison keeps it on third and short, and he gets snuffed. A loss of one.
Defensively.
Another punt for Ryan Nowicki. Trying to work the hop. Stevens takes it on a line, though. Stevens. Here he goes, and he's spun down at midfield by the punter.
What has been the biggest surprise so far?
Well, just the welcoming, you know, a Southern boy coming up north. You never know what to expect, and it's been unbelievable, and I really just can't wait to get started.
Well, you guys know all about Southern boys, Tom.
All right, thanks, Laura. And you can expect Garrett Dieter to come up for a big play every now and then, and that's a 51-yard scoring strike. And they didn't waste any time on that scoring drive. Well, Mike Jinks took the job. He told his new athletic director,
to drive down, keep the football, and score some points.
Over the head of Derek Keaton. And so Georgia Southern needs to answer in a big way.
They're averaging 25 yards per catch between the four receivers that have caught passes for Bowling Green. That's outstanding work.
Breida again, only able
on it. Darian Foreman, Roscoe Bird, the right guard, the UAB transfer, center and two guards. They want to work some things inside now.
Option pitch. Breida finds the edge, and he's got the sideline. Breida finally cut down in Bowling Green territory. There's the first big play for the kid with elite speed. It goes for 36 before Hardy brought him down.
Yeah, playing at less than 100%, but what a read by quarterback Kevin Ellison here. Working the edges, pulling the defense to him, attacking. If he just kind of meanders out there, they can play in the gray area between the pitch man and the quarterback, but he attacks the edge, forces the defender to take him, and then that gives the edge to Matt Breida. And we talked about his home run hitting ability all night long, finally getting loose.
He did leave with a noticeable limp after that run, so his time is going to have to be measured tonight. He's one of just four running backs in the country with a pair of 80-yard rushes this season. L.A. Ramsby spells him at running back.
That's when you get the edges.
Miles Campbell in the backfield for the first time tonight. They fake it right to Campbell, and Ellison is able to pick up four. And it's going to leave third down. Austin Valdez
for Kevin Ellison.
Saul Valdez, he already has four tackles tonight. First team All-MAC performer. He'll lead the play clock. And now take a timeout facing a third and three. With 9:04 to go in the second quarter
timeout
here in
Georgia
Mobile.
Southern.
Bowling Green
first
with a
half.
20-9 advantage. Offense still on the field, out of the timeout on third and three. Ramsby goes straight ahead and only finds one, and that will leave fourth.
He elects to go for it here, and I agree with him.
So fourth and two.
Well, you need some momentum, you need points. You need to keep this drive going, and kind of stymie some of the momentum that Bowling Green has.
Ellison gives it up. Ramsby just tripped up. And he's got enough for the first
down.
That number really only matters to Georgia Southern. Bowling Green has shown they can score at will at any time. Here's Wesley Fields with the cutback and the open field. Touchdown Eagles on a 26-yard run from Wesley Fields.
Doug Roos talked about Wesley Fields and the future he has. You see here, starting to the right. Puts that right foot in the ground and changes directions. And he had everybody flowing to the defense's left. When he changed direction, there was no one there between he and the end zone. Nice gamble that paid off on fourth down. for Dale McGee.
Extra point is good from Young Wei Koo. Nate Locke has a 4.0 in psychology. That might put him on someone's couch down the road. It was a worm burner handled off one hand by Clint Stevens at the five. And he gets dropped just inside the 20 into another facility after he slid headfirst into the fence surrounding the stadium. He did come back in and play after that initial collision.
Darius White.
Second down and 10. Handoff. Wrong way. Fred Coppett got swallowed. It's a loss of two. Nardo Govan with the tackle.
Nice job of fighting off a block, and then you get in space. You've got to make a play. Nardo Govan here is able to fight his way through and then cause a nice third and 11, exactly what Georgia Southern needs. Now they've got to get off the field.
Nice play by the former tight end. Had to fight back from a devastating knee injury early in the season last year. Play clock in single digits for Bowling Green. That's a rarity. And the Georgia Southern fans all on their feet. Johnson fires, and it's knocked away. Tay Hicklin with the big-time play. And momentum on the side of the Eagles.
You talk about an emotional player. He's the guy that had the big hit on Ronnie Moore. But here in pass coverage is a nice job coming through without making contact again with Ronnie.
Davidson will punt it away to Derek Keaton. Beautiful kick, and Keaton driven all the way back inside the 20. He'll let it roll, and that one will be down inside the 10.
Wow.
Joseph Davidson has a long
early this morning because of he's working late tonight.
First and 10 for Georgia Southern after the GoDaddy record long punt of 73 yards. Second and 9. Ellison on the draw and nothing doing there. We showed you injured cornerback Darius White, and for more on that injury update, let's check in with Laura.
Tom, Darius White will be going to the
to get a more in-depth look after he went headfirst into the fence surrounding the field. Third down for Georgia Southern. 7 yards to pick up the first.
It's one thing you don't see a lot. Big Andy Kwan inside, left-handed snapper. It's just many centers that snap the ball left-handed.
He's out front blocking here on another draw, and Ellison is able to pick up the first down. Same play, back-to-back, Taylor Royster filing with the tackle.
And watch Andy Kwan work to the next level. They invite the defense up the field. It's that block right there by Kwan that gives Kevin Ellison enough room to maneuver, to lunge for the first down and pick it up. What a nice job there inside by big Andy Kwan, a second-team All-Sun Belt player.
178 yards on the ground for Georgia Southern. They lead the nation with 356 a game. They scored on their opening drive. Offsides for Bowling Green. Ellison with the keeper. Alfonso Mack was coming on the corner.
Offsides, number 26. Defense, 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Still first down.
First side, you're 10 and you can't, you know, throw the ball with consistency. You've got to rely on a lot of other things to do it.
They rely on old reliable, the option, and Breida has the sideline, finally shoved out of bounds by Trent Green.
To take place with Breida once the pitch is delivered.
11 first downs for Georgia Southern, a program that leads the nation. Here is Ellison, trying to come up with a stiff arm. He got smoked, and we got three flags on the play. Denard Turner came up, and Ellison trying to stretch out his neck.
Yeah, I think it's a horse collar by Turner to bring down Kevin Ellison, and this will be a 15-yarder.
Personal foul, horse collar tackle, number 20, defense. 15-yard penalty added to the end of the run. Automatic, first down.
It's actually Trenton Green that draws the flag. You see him here trying to fight off a block, and then just grabs the back of it. He knew it. Tried to let go, but it was already too late.
Green has a reputation as a big hitter. Home of that cat. L.A. Ramsby in the backfield with Ellison. Ramsby with a stiff arm, changes direction, still on his feet, but smothered for a loss.
Yeah,
Shannon Smith, first man there, lost it.
In this style of offense, another point I'd like to make, we haven't seen Kevin Ellison go under center. They have yet this season to take a snap from under center.
Ellison will throw for the second time tonight, and it's incomplete. Over the top of his intended receiver, Monte Crump. Heavy, heavy to the run side.
Yeah, and in most option attacks you see, you watch Navy play, everything pretty much is under center. You watch Georgia Tech under center. This is a little bit different way of getting to the option.
Four-man rush, another passing opportunity over the middle, complete! A first down and a big lick on B.J. Johnson. Georgia Southern moves the chain on that gain of 17.
You said Kevin Ellison couldn't throw a dime over the middle. Nice job of not only delivering the football, but stepping up into the pocket to shoot one to B.J. Johnson.
B.J. Johnson has been injured this year. He suffered a broken clavicle in the game against Idaho, and he just took a big hit.
And missed a big portion of the season with that injury to his clavicle, but well, I tell you, right between defenders, actually, it's helmet-to-helmet contact. Could easily have been a targeting flag.
Yeah, on Clint Stevens, he delivered that hit and first met the face mask of B.J. Johnson. Georgia Southern fans reacting to the replay they saw on the big board. And some Georgia Southern players pointing out to Stevens, they think he went high.
Yeah, he did go high.
Yeah, they saw him go high. How about that?
We have the luxury of seeing it on replay, though, but there's no doubt that should have been a targeting flag.
So a couple pass attempts in this eight-play drive for Georgia Southern. That last one giving them a first down. Here comes the blitz. Spinning away, but losing his footing was Ramsby. No gain.
So close to breaking runs against this Bowling Green defense.
Second down, 10. Ellison has nowhere to go, defended perfectly, then he slips through. They had two men there. They had the quarterback covered and the pitch man. And all he did was make his guy miss for a gain of five.
Well, he's so good at showing it and then keeping it that it's fooled Bowling Green on a couple of occasions here. Watch him show it out there and keep it. Well, and that's the move there, the step back to make a defender miss. That's what makes him allow nice work.
Ellison averaging 5.5 yards a carry. To throw it again and incomplete. Trying to work it into Miles Camp.
Calm and collected. You knew this moment wouldn't be too big for him. He's made some good decisions, nice decisions throughout this game.
Fourth and five, pressure coming. Ellison able to escape. Now he steps and throws, launches it deep, end zone, touchdown, Monte Crockett on fourth and five, a 31-yard heave.
We saw Matt Johnson do it. Why not? Perfect job of improvising by Kevin Ellison, a broken play. He turns it into a big-time touchdown pass, keeping your eyes down the field, playing through the whistle.
Young Waiku for the extra point. And that capped a 12-play, 92-yard scoring drive on the catch by Monte Crockett, the junior from Rock Hill, South Carolina, his first catch of the season.
I'll tell you what, just watch the elusiveness of Kevin Ellison. Here, makes one defender miss, then he's going to get outside the pocket. The presence of mind does just look, take a look. Let me see if I got something down there. And on the end of it, Monte Crockett reeling in his first touchdown catch of the year.
That's only
had to make in this game, and they've worked out. Definitely have worked in his favor going into halftime.
Into the win, it's another worm burner scooped up by the tight end, Derek Lee. And Lee takes it to the 35. Fun one here. Let's go back to the studio and check in with Chris Cotter. Northern Illinois just couldn't find that offense. Matt Johnson with 122 to go. Plenty of time. He's able to swing it out to Garrick Dieter, who steps out of bounds after a gain of...
For Bowling Green, this is plenty of time for Matt Johnson.
Tried to pump and go. Good coverage downfield. Backing up, and he fires incomplete. 109 remaining. Now third
born for an easy score here before the half.
And by the way, he's got the wind at his back. To the ground game, and Travis Green breaks free. High steps his way down the sideline and finally shoved out of bounds by Matt Dobson. Forget about the aerial attack.
Still have three timeouts in their back pocket.
We are only 28 seconds into this drive, and already they've made this progress. Johnson keeps it, tried to make a man miss, and got taken down by...
Let a little bit of this time run down.
Here's Green again, moving the pile, and he pushes his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Travis Green from 5 yards out. And Bowling Green needs less than a minute to answer. 51-second drive.
Alex Huff.
Tyler Tate for the extra point. He's had one block tonight. Punches that one through. Five plays, 66 yards and 51 seconds off the clock. Travis Green, new stuff on the left side of the closet, so I don't grab the wrong pullover and I'm going to recruit. He slipped on the kick on his wet turf to Tate. Keaton able to scoop it up off the 11. Flag down, and Keaton takes it to the 34. 29 seconds remaining in the half. Here's his
There's no foul for a block in the back. The block was deemed to have occurred from the side. First down.
All right, so we get that cleared up. Back at it. They've got two timeouts remaining. Four yards up the middle.
That should do it.
Another tackle for Shannon Smith. He's been busy for Bowling Green on the interior of this line. They're playing without Zach Colvin today, the fifth-year senior. Suffered a cracked sternum late in the season. So a fun one here, a little bit of everything. 27-23 Bowling Green. Laura Rutledge will be with Bowling Green coach Brian Ward coming up on the Coke Zero Halftime Report. Now let's go to Chris Cotter, Todd McShay, and Joey Galloway for the Coke Zero Halftime Report. Welcome back to the GoDaddy Bowl, part of Capital One Bowl Mania. And a maniacal first half here in Mobile with Georgia Southern playing in its first ever bowl game against the MAC champs from Bowling Green.
The number ops to maybe put some distance between themselves once they regain the lead, if they regain the lead in this game.
Derek Keaton back to return in a driving rainstorm, and this kick somehow is driven into the wind and through the back of the end zone. Georgia Southern will start the second half on offense.
Has yet to put on a rain jacket.
Yeah, he doesn't care. He doesn't have time for the rain or rain jacket or whatever might keep him dry. He's just out here to coach some football. Fabian Upshaw starting the second half at quarterback, and he's able to pick up four. Pat Dye was fired. We knew he was gone before the Iron Bowl. We had to make that adjustment, and you just got to grow up and deal with it.
Yeah, it was a great message to his team and how they prepare and who the next coach is coming in and what type of offense they're going to run. All of those things are, you know,
36-yard run on an option pitch, and you hate to see that for Breida. He did pick up the first down. Bad snap. Upshaw has to fall on it, and a smart play to do just that.
Right back. Then it's tough.
A loss of 10. Upshaw with the option. Pitch man covered, so he takes it himself, and he's able to get up the sideline on a big gain of 17. And that'll erase that 10-yard loss.
Yeah.
Receiver. They show corner blitz. They go option the opposite way. Upshaw able to cut it back for a first down.
Oh, he will stay in, and it's because of the element of speed that he brings to the offense.
It's interesting. Doug Ruse, the offensive coordinator, treats his quarterbacks like a lot of programs treat running backs, you know? Let's see who's got the hot hand.
Yeah.
Wesley Fields gets turned around.
Georgia Southern.
That's Kevin Ellison, their starting quarterback. Did not start this second half. Once again, able to control the clock.
Watch that play clock tick down inside of 10.
They try to find the edge with Wesley Fields. Field.
The yards that matter to me as a running back coach.
Third down, 2. Fields has the first.
Just like that.
Yep.
Eagle yards. Job by the true freshman Wesley Fields.
They split Upshaw out. They've got Breida in to take the direct snap. Breida fresh off the bike back on the turf, and they string him out. He's able to get maybe.
I think he can still be effective between the tackles. It's laterally as when it's really going to affect him.
10th play of the drive. The previous 9 have all been on the ground. Campbell in motion. They're going to throw for the first time this drive, and it's a deep out complete.
Nice.
For a first down. That's Keegan Williams with the grab, a gain of 17, only his 3rd catch of the year.
Nice job of working the sideline, pushing the defender off. Watch the top of your screen, gets him turned, and then a nice break to the sideline. And how about that from Fabian Upshaw? The timing on the throw right out of the break so that Keegan Williams catches it and gets himself right on out of bounds.
Brian Ward reiterated to Laura before the half that this is a concern of his, Georgia Southern's passing game, but he broke it down with us in 2 distinctly different scenarios last night. I'll tell you after this play. Upshaw lost it and able to pounce on it. He said, you know, Del McGee said, our biggest concern, negative play, is on offense, is what he told Laura at the half. Upshaw pulls it back, eludes pressure, burst to the outside, and is down to the 21. Alfonso Mack cuts
that short of those 3 or 4 extra yards that he may have picked up.
A long drive, 12 plays, 54 yards. Bowling Green's had to sub in some of their second string guys now. Here's Fields, slips through. Wesley Fields inside the 10, and he lowers his shoulder to get inside the 5. 18-yard run for Fields, another big play for the Eagles. Back in at tailback. First and goal, Georgia Southern looking to reclaim the lead. Option. Upshaw keeps. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. Eagles back in front on the 3-yard run.
Boy, excellent block on the edge by James Dean. The tight end just chops down the edge and made it an easy, just paved an easy route to the end zone for Fabian Upshaw. Watch number 33 right here. The kick down, the block right there going low. That's what frees up the quarterback to just walk into the end zone untouched.
That was a 7.5-minute drive. 14 plays to cover 75 yards in Georgia Southern. Up by a field goal. Their calling card is the option. Fabian Upshaw with his 3rd rushing touchdown of the season, to the delight of Del McGee.
The game, and everybody gets to watch you go to the sideline after a long run. That irritates me to no end.
That kick through the end zone. Georgia Southern able to.
The offense is giving you a nice long rest to start the second half. You got to figure out a way to slow down this Bowling Green offense.
Johnson able to complete it to the edge to Roger Lewis since the beginning of the second quarter. That is only the 10th play run, 2.5 minutes for Bowling Green since the end of the first quarter.
Yeah, but it doesn't take Bowling Green long to get themselves rolling.
It does limit their opportunity.
1.5-minute drives. Now offensively, when we get the ball back, we have to go score. We got to go match that right now, because they get it back, they could put together another 7.5-minute drive to put even more pressure on Bowling Green.
It really shortens the game. 3rd and 3 now. Coppett in the backfield. Johnson gave it to him, trying to run behind the big fellas. He's right up the back of Alex Huddle, who's making his 55th career start today. 3rd longest streak in the country.
Just kind of can remember that. But has been a model of consistency for this program.
And running behind him, they're able to pick up the first down. Now they go the opposite way and able to find 5 yards on the ground for Coppett. Aquinas.
Kind of showing they have a running game as well, Bowling Green.
Johnson pulls it back. Deep ball. Incomplete. Roger Lewis.
Maybe just being in the area to interfere with the concentration of Roger Lewis.
So a key third down. After Georgia Southern reclaimed the lead, can they get the ball back third and five? Johnson goes deep again. Flag on the play. Pass was incomplete. Antonio Glover didn't turn around on Ronnie Moore. And that will give the Falcons the first.
Already made contact.
Yep. So a third. My quarterback's going to be in my ear all game to try and mix it up. Here comes a safety blitz. They get the screen away and room for Ronnie Moore. Moore rips off the 23-yard gain on the catch and run. Antoine Williams finally brought him down.
Safety blitz. Where's the voided area? Right in the middle of the field. And you saw Ronnie Moore, who's excellent with the ball in his hands after the catch.
So first the flag and then that one for 23. And Bowling Green finding some rhythm again. They let the play clock get down to five. Johnson hands it off to Coppett. And he is gang tackled. Ryan George leading. That ball was out. But even if he wasn't down in terms of having his knees down, I wonder if the forward progress had been stopped. Five men in routes here. Johnson tried to spin free and he gets dropped. Ironhead Gallon, first sack of the night for Georgia Southern. It's a loss of eight.
And he's got tremendous speed, Tom. Watch 27. He delays the blitz, sees the opening, and now it's just me and the quarterback. Johnson being smart, knowing that he's not going to outrun Ironhead Gallon.
Offensive line, it sounds like a big number, but as many plays as they run and as often as they're in passing situations, they've been pretty consistent this year. Third and 16 to the run game in Green. And Green able to get six of it. Manageable. But
well, for Bowling Green, no doubt about it, it's manageable.
Most coaches would be cringing at fourth and 10. They've already converted one fourth down. It went for a touchdown tonight. Here's Green. Nowhere to go. He only found a yard. And Georgia Southern with the stop. Govan with another big play.
Surprised with a play call, all the explosiveness on the outside. They try to fool them with a draw play, and Georgia Southern ready for it.
They only ran nine plays in the second quarter, but 10 plays on this drive for Bowling Green, and nothing to show for it. They turn it over on downs. Fabian Upshaw still a quarterback for Georgia Southern. He's been a maestro here in the second half. Breida and Fields in the backfield. Upshaw straight ahead. Fabian Upshaw, world-class speed. And the foot race belongs to the quarterback. 80-yard sprint.
4.3 speed in the 40, and you see why he's left in the game. Right up the middle. Watch the play fake. Everybody's going with Breida. It's clean, untouched. Now it's just a foot race by Fabian Upshaw. Nobody on the field is going to catch that young man.
7 rushes, 111 yards, and 2 touchdowns. Career-long run for the redshirt junior Fabian Upshaw. The only downside, the record won't stand. This sprint was wind-aided. Fabian Upshaw takes it 80 yards straight ahead, and Georgia Southern adds to its lead. First ever bowl game for Georgia Southern, and it's just like old times. They're rolling in the postseason. up by 10 against Bowling Green tonight. Up 10, Georgia Southern kicks it away. No return. After our game, stick around for SportsCenter at night with John Buchegross and Jay Harris. So
this is exactly what you wanted. Georgia Southern to put the pressure. Now it's a two-score game. Put a lot of pressure on Bowling Green to have to go get points.
Touch pass. Wow! Big play! Chris De La Rosa. Loss of five. Perfectly scouted. He devoured Scott Miller.
Yeah, fourth tackle for a loss on the season. Perfect position. Right? Unblock, step up, keep leverage. I'm going to keep him inside, so if I miss, I've got some help, but he didn't need it.
Three-man line now. Ball lost by Johnson. Georgia Southern falls on it.
I think it just slipped right out of his hand. And if you played the position of quarterback, it's happened to everybody. If it hadn't, it's going to. We see it here, the play fake inside to Green, and it just comes right out. And it could easily happen on a night like this when the elements are less than ideal. This comes right out of his hands.
Nardo Govan has made some big plays tonight for Georgia Southern, and that one not only takes a possession away from Bowling Green, but it's got Georgia Southern knocking on the door.
You're just hoping when that happens to you that you can recover it and play on the next down. But this is tough for Bowling Green if Georgia Southern gets in the end zone here.
Option, Upshaw, great footwork, and it gets taken down at the one. 13-yard carry. Terrence Book
came to Georgia Southern. No, he's not going to catch the football a bunch, but just playing some unselfish football.
Upshaw with the pitch to Breida. He's got room. Touchdown, Matt Breida. 17th touchdown of the season for Breida.
If I'm giving him MVPs or if I'm giving game balls tonight, I'm giving it to James Dean, number 33, who threw a block for Fabian Upshaw to get in the end zone the last drive. This time it's for Matt Breida to get himself into the end zone. We'll come back and take a look at that. The outside chopped out block by James Dean is paving the way for guys to get in the end zone.
Two high scoring teams meeting tonight in Mobile, but it's Georgia Southern who's hung 44 on the board.
Watch number 33 come into your screen right here. This block right here that takes place. Watch the chop down block. That allows Matt Breida to walk into the end zone. Not easy to do, but he's done it on a couple of occasions to free guys up and get them into the end zone untouched. Unbelievable.
Yes, sir. Line drive kick almost knocked Miller over. Third quarter, it's a smile on Gus's face.
Gus is smiling all the time. Then.
Johnson keeps it, trying to find the edge. Not known for his wheels, but he slides to a. This is a rarity.
Holding, number 83, offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Still first down.
Senior Derek Lee gets flagged. For a hold. Johnson to the air. It is hauled in by Roger Lewis. Caleb Williams with the back at the 15.
On the play, both by the offense. Pass interference, number one, offense. That penalty is declined. Holding, number 83, offense. That penalty be accepted. Half the distance to the goal. Still first down.
Is that how Derek Lee wanted to hear
for
the senior tight end?
Watch him right here work and just right there. Anytime you go high and grab the shoulder pads.
That was the penalty that was declined. They called it pass interference on Roger Lewis.
Yeah, a little bit of a push off and an extension.
Bowling Green won't mind when this quarter comes to an end.
Once the arm extends, they're going to catch you every time. Get to the edge, you can make defenders miss, but
ball's on the ground again.
Oh boy.
Johnson tried to pull it back on the run pass option and couldn't hold on to it. Georgia Southern football.
Oh boy. We talked about it. One of the keys to this game was to handle the weather. Handle the conditions, and right now they're getting to Matt Johnson. A fumble the previous drive there, ball handling, not secure. It comes out of his hands again and sets up Georgia Southern at point-blank range once again.
Nardo Govan with his second fumble recovery. What a game for a guy who's had to deal with injury. And why not? He's been magnificent. He's got Breida behind him. Here's Breida straight ahead. And he gets Georgia Southern up on Bowling Green 44-27 as we start the fourth quarter. Let's go down to the sideline, Laura Rutledge.
As you'd imagine, Tom, the Georgia Southern sideline, yet he said, we still have one quarter to play. And he said, I want to see you guys finish.
That's great. And the great point to make, it's really about the defense realizing that. I mean, the offense has to finish this drive, but Bowling Green can score in bunches.
True sign of leadership right there. Understands the game.
Here's the option. Upshaw again's in. 8-yard touchdown run. His third touchdown of the night.
Oh, nice block by Darian Foreman, the left guard, who pulls around. They get tired of using James Dean, I guess, to chop people down on the edges. They pull the big fella, Darian Foreman, around. A first-team All-Sun Belt player to pave the way for Fabian Upshaw.
And so it's a 51-27 advantage for Georgia Southern. This is a team that won 6 FCS national champions. Big key for Bowling Green, the second half turnovers. As you're talking about dealing with the weather. Now they do have the wind at their back. That kick almost went unfielded. Now trying to make some room, Hervé Kobe. And finally able to get to the 17-yard line. Now Fabian Upshaw.
In a hurry. Plenty of time on the clock.
See that drive chart for Georgia Southern. Yeah, they're scoring at will, and they're doing it quickly. Now, complete. Great one.
Two consecutive possessions. You need completions.
And here's Garrick Dieter on the screen. Able to find four. Have those turnovers in this rain and in these weather conditions, knowing that you have such a prolific offense in your hands.
The thing now for Georgia Southern is not to give up a big play. You can't give one up over the top.
Here's a deep ball just off the hands of Roger Lewis. Only 3 catches. Travis Green motions out of the backfield. Johnson complete. Great hands by Ronnie Moore. He's been reliable tonight. 30 consecutive games with a reception for the junior Moore.
If I'm Del McGee, I'm okay with that. It's a first down. Just make them earn it. Make them put together an 8-10 play drive.
Johnson steps in, steps back, uncorks one deep down the left sideline. It is incomplete. Dieter had it for a split second. Caleb Williams able to separate him from the football.
Just at the last second, he sees the receiver's hands go up, plays it perfectly to just rake the arms of Garrick Dieter, causing the football to come out. That is well played.
Play whistle dead before the snap. Timeout taken by Georgia Southern.
Timeout, Georgia Southern, first of the half. Immediate timeout.
51-27, 13:47 to go. And here in Mobile.
Caleb Williams continuing to play some pretty good football.
Third down, 10. Flag, somebody flinched, looked like Georgia Southern. And Jamal Johnson.
It looks like it's going to be a false start.
False start. Number 55. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
I'm having a nice workout. My man is
He is put together.
Johnson chased on third and long, and he flicks it behind his head as he's being brought down by Govan, who's been a monster.
You talk about some closing speed. 6'2", 250.
That's out of number.
Yeah, the down and distance marker, so excellent call.
Well, they're punting it away 2 minutes into the fourth quarter with the wind at their back. Takes a great hop, and Bowling Green is able to push Georgia Southern back with great field position. Now it's up to Bowling Green's defense. 82 through the air. 439 yards of offense on the evening, and now trying to advance it in a monsoon. Upshaw gives it up to L.A. Ramsey, a flag on the play.
Yeah, maybe a hold inside.
Holding, number 93, defense. That 10-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. The penalty results in first down.
Holding defensively, and usually that
will take Georgia Southern to a first down and out to the 21-yard line.
It gives them some room in which to breathe.
Upshaw gives it up to Ramsby again. L.A. Ramsby, sophomore from Cincinnati.
Yeah, move it. On the ground between the two guards. We're turning it over to you.
Blitz coming up the middle. Ramsby goes right there on second and four and picks up four. Maybe. Denard Turner with the stop.
And a
football. Remember, they never go under center, so out of the shotgun with Fields behind it. Fields trying to make a move behind the line. Needed less than a yard, but didn't get it. In fact, he may have lost a yard. So, fourth down, up 51-27. Three previous since intermission. Lonnie Moore back to receive this one. A line drive. Takes it at the 25. Lonnie Moore sandwiched at the 41. 9:52 to go in Mobile. 46-yard punt, 17-yard. Quiet second half for Bowling Green. Matt Johnson itching to get something going. Deep ball, sideline, incomplete, no flag. Coverage by Caleb Williams. Robbie Rhodes, the intended receiver, pleading his case.
Well, and he is an explosive young man. At one point, he was at Baylor, played as a true freshman, was the number one overall recruit in the state of Texas coming out of high school. Down, the chains moving. You've got plenty of time left in this game.
Only 59 yards in the second half for Johnson. Batted away, Caleb Williams on Derek Dieter.
How about him?
There was no one on campus they were comfortable with. So then with the JUCO route, they found him at Tyler Junior College. And he's had a monster night tonight against his high-powered Bowling Green offense. Another punt, and this one carries into the end zone. 9:25 to go. That was a 60-yard punt. Bowling Green's offense
in here, and they can just kind of go about their business. Moving the chains, picking up first downs, and working on this clock.
The hero of the game with another big run, Fabian Upshaw, rips off 12. The clock will be down below 5 seconds before they snap it. Upshaw gives it up to Matt Breida. Breida trying to churn his way, finds 4 yards.
Matt Breida, he's earned my respect tonight. Because I know that's not an easy way to play football. So a tough enough game, and then you factor in the surface. Slipping and sliding, it's tough.
Junior from Brooksville, Florida. There's a lot of uncertainty around this program when the coaching staff, and Willie Fritz the first to say he's taking the head job at Tulane, and it's expected that just about the entire coaching staff will follow him there. At least they'll have the opportunity to. And so the big question is, you know, if you're part of this program and you've worked hard for playing time within an option offense, what's next? Who's going to come in, especially offensively? And from South Georgia, that was a key for him and his family, and certainly a key for athletic director Tom Kleinlein. He also bears a striking resemblance, according to the... would have been their game in Athens against Georgia early this season. It led in the second half for the first time in that series history. They ended up losing in overtime after going for it on fourth and goal. Here's Ramsby. Past midfield, down to the 45-yard line, 15-yard
it here in the fourth quarter.
403 yards on the ground for Georgia Southern tonight. Breida hard into the hole, lost the, well, didn't lose the football. He just went down quickly. Well documented his ankle injury in the finale against Georgia State. Wesley Fields, according to Lord, just learned that he's out with a left hand injury. Had a great first half. Here he is, the man of the moment, Fabian Upshaw. He's got the angle and the speed, and he's in again. 42-yard run for a touchdown run of the night. And Andre's buying lottery tickets later.
Well, you just knew that everybody's crashing inside. You show it in there, and you got a speedster like Fabian Upshaw, that you get him one-on-one. If one defender misses, it's over. How about the game that young man has played since coming in?
And his roommate, Kevin Ellison, the starting quarterback, first man to meet him on the sideline to offer congratulations. A career night for Fabian Upshaw. Touchdown runs of 3, 80, 8, and now 42 yards for the junior from Titusville, Florida. Taken off like a rocket again, and Georgia Southern is cruising. Just the first in program history for Georgia Southern, a team that had great success in the Southern Conference at the FCS level. They won 6 national championships behind Irk Russell and Paul Johnson.
They're roommates, great teammates, right? They're playing the same position. Amazing.
Yeah, they're roommates and they're great friends. And one of the things that the coaches talked about in regard to this position,
you're different that way. You are coming downhill fast, so you're going to take some violent hits.
This is Travis Green, and he takes it past the 30, up to the 31. Matt Dobson with the, given the way this thing has played out, 58 points on the board for Georgia Southern, a team
Amazing.
That lost its finale against Georgia State and was out of rhythm the entire game. Johnson slides down just shy of the first down marker. It'll be fourth and short.
What in the game in which I think they went 3 or 4 consecutive drives of putting it in and the ability to take advantage of turnovers? He may be short here on fourth and one.
If he is, it'll be the second time Bowling Green has turned it over on downs. We're talking with some of the Bowling Green guys yesterday. Taylor Royster.
They were putting in bits and pieces of how to defend Navy all season long.
Well, right, but the difference is for a coach like that, you know you have an option team on your schedule. Bowling Green didn't.
Yep.
And it's another big stop on fourth down for the Georgia Southern defense. Another turnover on downs, and they can salt away the last 3:35.
Well, even with a couple of...
Chaz Thornton in the backfield. College football playoff semifinals are finally upon us. The games we've been waiting... Here's Chaz Thornton again. There it is. A splash for Del McGee, interim head coach. A lot of the guys in the Georgia Southern program wanted him to be named the head coach. He was one of the candidates. But he said these guys have to deal with adversity and move on.
It's got to be tough for him, though. You get to know, you spend so much time around these young men, and it's part of the business, but it never gets easy.
On 3rd and 13, Upshaw for good measure. First ever bowl game for Georgia Southern. They're 23 seniors, part of now 30. This sleepy little farming town, short drive from the Georgia coast. Home of a bowl champion now. Their program didn't exist between World War II and 1982. Irk Russell rebuilt the thing with a bare-bones budget. They bought their first football at a Kmart. They put athletic stripes with tape down the middle of their helmet. 1989, the first 15-0 season in modern football history. Paul Johnson was their offensive coordinator, came back to lead them to national championships as a coach. Guys like Adrian Peterson, who eventually played for the Bears, Paul Johnson, Irk Russell,
Tracy Ham,
magnificent player and a College Football Hall of Famer. Now 2015, you can add another line. First bowl win. They started their day today in the basement of the team hotel, riding out a tornado warning at 7 o'clock in the morning. By 4 o'clock, they're on the familiar Yellow Dog school buses for the short ride over to Ladd Peebles Stadium. And now, at 10:30 Central Time, Georgia Southern, with a full day, will wrap up its first ever bowl victory in its first ever bowl game. Quite a day and quite a season for this remarkable program from Statesboro, Georgia.
That'll do it.
Fabian Upshaw and Georgia Southern knock off Bowling Green 58-27. GoDaddy champs in their first ever bowl game. And the man of the hour, Fabian Upshaw, 12 carries, 199 yards, averaging 16 and a half yards per carry, and 4 touchdowns on the ground. And he's standing by with Laura Rutledge.
Thanks, Fabian. You knew you'd have a chance to get in this game, but you had to give coaches a reason to leave you in. What made the difference?
I just want to go out here and play hard for my seniors. I mean, this meant a lot to us. You know, coaching change and everything like that. We just banded together and wanted to play for each other.
You mentioned that coaching change. Del McGee said he told you guys you'd have to get through this adversity. How did this team come together and win this game?
I mean, we all believe in Coach McGee. We love him. And he believed in us, so we just banded together and do what we did the whole season, just play for each other.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, they did play for each other. It was evident in the way Kevin Ellison treated his quarterback teammate and roommate Fabian Upshaw. A game for the ages, a historical night for Georgia Southern. Once again, our final score, Eagles 58, Bowling Green 27. Coming up next at SportsCenter. Tune into the postgame trophy ceremony by Capital One. Coming up next on ESPN3. Good night. Merry Christmas from Mobile.